they can work on maybe together to try to help these victims?
Tara, I want to hear from you.
Here's the bottom line. Today was not supposed to be about Donald Trump, but he's such a malignant narcissist that he cannot allow 1 minute of one day, even in the wake of two massacres in this country, to go by without it being about him. He's not the consoler in chief. He never will be. He's the victim in chief. Everything about him is about victimizing poor me. I mean, for goodness sakes, pull up your big boy pants and act like the president of the United States and rise to the occasion for once. I mean, come on. You can't sit here and tell me, Rick Santorum, that you looked at the way the president behaved today and you were proud of that. Is that what you want as the president of the United States? You're proud of that? Because that's an embarrassment. He acted like a five-year-old because he couldn't take some criticism. He couldn't take the protesters. I mean, for goodness sakes, he couldn't even remember the name of Glendon Oakley, who was a hero in El Paso that saved children. But he was happy to stand there and take a photo op with the black guy who was a hero. I mean, he couldn't even bother to remember his name. But the first thing that came out of his mouth was, oh my goodness, everyone, it was such an amazing day today. Amazing? People died. People died in El Paso. Partly because of the rhetoric that he's incited with white supremacists in this country. And he's talking about what an amazing day it was because he got a couple of hugs and slaps on the back in the hospital in Dayton. It's ridiculous. We are talking about the fight for the soul of America, as Joe Biden so eloquently discussed today. And this right here, what the president is doing, this cannot be what the American people deserve.
The reality is that the people who have been politicizing this moment has not been the President of the United States. It's been the Democratic candidates for president, as well as a lot of local elected officials.
They're not president. He is.
You know what? They are not president, but the president is a human being like everybody else, and he has a right to defend himself when he's being attacked, unlike any president during a time of crisis.
Today's not about him.
Every other president who has tried to be a uniter and a consoler was not met with this kind of hostility. They're just not. And you can say, well, he's different.
You're kidding.
But that's just simply not the case.
Obama wasn't met with this kind of hostility when people like you and other Republicans went after him, saying that he incited police violence when all that was going on with Black Lives Matter. You guys didn't go after him, claiming that that Barack Obama and Hillary Clinton were responsible for ISIS and therefore the Paris attack. You said that yourself. So don't sit here and tell me that Republicans didn't go after Obama the same way. They did, and I was one of them.
I'd just like to
intellectually honest about it.
I just like to. This business of